What's going on, guys? Welcome back. Today we are going to open up this little package sent to me by Mr. John Richards over at Ultimaider. Now, if you follow Ultimaider at all, you will know that they are coming out with a new product. And today we get to open this up and see it for ourselves. So let's get after it. Now, if you follow my channel, you know that I own everything that Ultimaider has put out. I have nothing but appreciation for everything that Mr. John has brought to the saddle hunting market, and he is able to do this because he is a saddle hunter himself, and he knows exactly what the saddle hunter needs. So, let's check out his new product here, and this is the compact gear strap. I've seen a couple of videos that he's put out on how to use this thing, and I was really hoping to get out and put this on the tree, but time got away from me today and it is already dark. So right now we are going to open this up. We are going to fiddle around with it and compare it to what I am using now. So one thing you see right away is you have three different length arms. Now I haven't measured this, but I can measure it right now. So the short one, you're going to get about 2.5 inches. Medium one, you're going to get about 4 inches. And the longer one, you're going to get about 5.5. He did put up some testing videos, and the longer one was the weakest one of them all. And that is just basic physics. So let's take this thing out of the package and see what we're working with here. So I got a new mic today. So maybe you guys can give me your thoughts on how the video sounds, if it sounds better than normal. You can see how compact that is. That is super small. Now, obviously, I'm not going to take the time to wrap this up just like this every time, so it's probably going to be even a little bit flatter. So I also think it's pretty cool that the packaging itself is 3D printed too, and it's even got Ultimaider in the top of it there, so that's pretty neat. So when you unravel it, which I've got most of it unraveled here, you can see it's wrapped around just like that. And when you unravel it all the way, you can see that it goes in through your hooks and back through your bow hook. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your tag in, push it through a little bit, and then you're gonna have a loop like that. So that what that does is it allows you to lift your bow hanger straight out of your hooks. So when you're packing it up, you do the opposite. And then when you pull it tight, it doesn't allow you to pull your bow hanger out. So you can flop that all over the place and it's not going to come out. So before I go over the next feature, I'm going to wrap this back up and we're going to compare it to my current setup. Man, I can't believe how small that is. This is my current setup. And so what this is a tethered hitch strap with the Genesis 3D printing fulcrum bow hanger. Now, don't get me wrong. I love this thing and it served me very well and I will not be getting rid of it. It would definitely serve as a backup, but I've got three hooks strategically placed, you know, around this. Basically, when you put this around the tree and you hook it in, you've got a hook in the back of the tree, a hook in the front of the tree, and my bow hanger off to the left side. And then I've also got another hook right here to hang my backpack off of the tag end. Now, that's all fine and well, and it worked great. And I will say again, I have nothing against this bow hanger. This bow hanger is awesome. One thing I can say that I don't particularly like about it is that whenever you fold it flat, regardless of if it's got a strap on it or not, it does not fold flat. It's got that angle to it. So whenever you try to wrap anything around it, it kind of just slides down and will eventually come off. So unless you want to take the time to put these hooks on every single time and take them off every single time, there's really no easy way to wrap up this sis hauler. So you kind of just wind up wrapping it all up together, and this rat's nest is what you're left with. Like I said, I've used this for 2 years and it has served me very well, but there's better options. All right, so what I would wind up doing when I get set up in the tree is I would pull my gear hanger out, I would unhook it and unravel, go ahead and feed a little bit through, pull some slack, separate it, and then I would grab this bow hanger with my left hand, I would reach around the tree, and I would grab my hooks, and I would bring my hooks around to the front of the tree. On the other end is two loops. One is a grab handle, and the other one is to hook your loop in. That way, when you pull, you have a handle to hold on to. So you pull your slack out, and you're around the tree, and then you can separate these hooks and spread them out wherever you need them. You can put one way around on the back of the tree, one just like that, and then you'd have your bow hanger over to your left, and you're all set up. So then whenever you're ready to pack up, you undo your hook, put your hooks back together, pull your slack out to your other end there, put in your bow hanger, roll it around, nest your bow hanger into your hooks, pull your slack out, wrap it up. Then, if you pull your hook down here to about 7 or 8 inches from the end, when you get done wrapping it up, and then you take this end, your tag end, below your hook, continue to wrap it, and you can hook it onto your hook there. So that's all nice and neat, packed up, and you can't get much smaller than that. You're talking about a bow hook, your strap, and 3 separate gear hooks all packed into this little package. Now, one of the major things that I do like about this is he's already proven that these hooks are pretty strong, and so I'm not worried about it holding up my gear, but you know, there's no dinging. All of these hooks that I've got on this thing here, as I'm putting it up, these hooks are all beating together and making a bunch of racket. That is a thing of the past. Now, one of the best features about this that makes this modular as far as the arm length goes, you know, it comes with a small arm, so rifle hunters, you know, can hook their sling over this and, you know, shouldn't have any problem. This length right here would be perfect for guys who shoot their bow or rifle, but shoot their bow with their quiver off, which that's me. I always take my quiver off because I don't practice with my quiver on, so I know, beat me up now. So this one would be good for the guys who like to keep their quiver on. You know, you'll notice that it keeps it further away from the tree, so you can hook your bow here and give you room between your bow and the tree. Or if you just like your bow to be hanging off the tree a little bit, you know, this will be the arm for you. So we're going to check this out and see how easy it is to change. So we are not going to take this off here. We're just going to fold it down. And this is a 532 Allen. The nut is sunk into the 3D printed plastic here, so you don't have to have a second tool to hold it. And your bolt comes straight out. So then you're left with 3 separate pieces here. So then you can take your medium arm, put it to the side, and stick your small arm in there, and then you would reverse the process. I'm eager to see what this looks like when it's packed up with this smaller arm. Now, you don't want that to be too tight, because if it is, it'll be hard to fold your arm down. So you're probably going to want to back it off just a little bit to give you that free float there. So let's see what she looks like. Remember what I said? Fold your tag end around. Hook it onto your hook right there. It's not going anywhere. So, I can almost close my fist around it, but let's just compare this size with, let's do it justice. Let's fold it up as tight as we can. Now, I don't know if you can actually see this, but this is absolutely half the size of this. I would say that it's very, very close in weight. I mean, I can even weigh it. 5.54 ounces. 8.39 ounces. So, even if you carry both of the extra arms, you got 5.54, add the longer arm to it, 6.79, add the medium arm to it, 7.76. So this whole thing right here, you know, which you probably wouldn't take these with you to the tree, this is 2/3 of the weight of this. So when I get back in the groove of things here pretty soon, I'm going to be doing some other videos. This is going to be incorporated into my saddle setup immediately. Matter of fact, I'm about to put the medium-sized arm back on it and put it directly into my saddle. So stay tuned for some other videos to see the compact gear strap in action. Plus, you guys might even get the chance to see me pull my bow off of this thing and let the air out of one this season. You guys should head on over to Ultimaider.com, home of the best one-stick aider on the market. Plus, he's got multiple other innovative products just for saddle hunters. Again, this is gear from a saddle hunter for us saddle hunters. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you next time in Rob's Man Cave.